There are no exact figures for the numbers of child soldiers used by the Sudan People's Liberation Army. But since 2001, more than 20,000 have been demobilized.
I believe I've survived for a reason to tell my story to touch lives. I believe I've survived for a reason to tell my story to touch lives. All people struggling down there. Storms only come for a while, then after a while, they'll be gone. Bless. My father was working for the government as a policeman. Few years later, I heard he joined a rebel movement that was formed to fight for freedom. I didn't understand the politics behind all this, cause I was only a child. After a while, I saw the tension rising high between the Christian and the Muslim regime. We lost our possession. My mother's mother suffered depression. And because of this, I was forced to be a war child.
Emmanuel Jal was born in southern Sudan and spent the early years of his childhood in the midst of its long-running civil war. At the age of 7, after the death of his mother, he was recruited as a child soldier for the rebel army. Amazingly, he survived frontline action and eventually managed to escape with 300 other lost boys. He endured a 3-month trek on foot without any supplies to reach safety. One of only a handful to survive the journey, Emmanuel was rescued by Emma McCune, a British aid worker, who smuggled him to freedom in Kenya and enrolled him in school for the first time.
She had an accident. There was a car crash. That's one of the moments I can remember that I actually cried, you know, because of the relationship she established between me and her.
This one goes to Emma McCune, angel to the rescue one afternoon. I'm here because you rescued me. I'm proud to carry your legacy. Thank you. Bless you. R.I.P.
What would I be if Emma never rescued me? What would I be? Another starving refugee. What would I be?
Our mission is to work with individuals, families, and communities to help them overcome the effects of war and poverty through education. Our objectives are the advancement of education for the public benefit by providing and assisting in the provisions of facilities for education.
Most of the African leaders, everyone is for themselves. They want to be served, they want to be recognized. I am the king, I am the boss. My prayer is to see the day when we'll have leaders who are willing to serve their people and not to be served.